Okay, I've had this lamp open for a while, and it's a few degrees cooler. That's about 65 at the hot spot there. In fact, 66, 67. So yeah, it may be most 5 degrees C cooler with it outside. Yeah, there's 67. This is pretty close. Got it down to 5 degrees C warmer inside the enclosures. I can't get any cooler than that without, I don't want to put a fan in there. That's kind of defeating the purpose. And then here I've got the Phillips bulb in my floor lamp. I've had it on for better than half an hour now. And we'll see what kind of, there's like 75 degree. Yeah, 80 degrees C on. Yeah, that is warm. The only thing is there's no ventilation underneath this, so it's not quite in free air, but it's pretty close. So I'll check it in the ventilated fixture and see what that looks like. Okay, this is the Phillips 10.5 watt bulb, and it's been going, I guess, about 45 minutes now. Hit 106 Fahrenheit. So why don't I pull the cover off and we'll check the bulb temperature with the heat gun. So again, okay, there were, yeah, that's not too bad. That's about what the bulb measures in, right around, yeah, there's a hot spot right in there. It measures up in the 80 degree range when it's out in free air, so it's still a little bit warmer than it is in free air. I think I've measured 80, low 80s, so there's a, looks like an 84. So that's over in that area where it's hot. Must be, looks like this side is much cooler, because I guess that's more in the airflow, so this side of the bulb is cooler than that side. Yeah, it seems like this side gets a little bit warmer than the other side, so I guess the heat, there's more airflow on this side of the bulb than there is on the other side. So I could try rotating it a bit and see if that makes a difference. Emitters on this bulb are right around, there's a series around this side facing up, and then there's the same emitters on the bottom facing down. Okay, here I had the Phillips light running, kind of tipped at an angle for about 40 minutes. And let's see what kind of temperature we get here. So we'll go light. Yeah, that's a little cooler, 80, 82. I think we have a winner here, because that's about as hot as it gets sitting out in the open air. I guess that side, there's a, right along the heat sink there, or the, I guess that's a fiberglass, two-layer fiberglass board with the emitters attached to it, so that's the hot, you can see right along there is kind of the hot point there. And yeah, I think putting this at a slight angle helps, because that kind of lets the air flow over the top and around a little better. So yeah, I think that is the winning position right there. So yeah, this bulb definitely runs hotter than this one. I guess all that heat sinking on there is actually real. They've got ventilation and then the heat sinking, and now this one gets hotter up on top. So the actual heat sink is actually I think, working. This Phillips bulb, it's, I guess they just didn't do quite the same thermal job, but I think this should be a good fit. So I'll try this bulb, and then I'll try a Cree bulb, maybe just as a third example, just to see if there's any difference there. So we'll try that, see how that looks.